I sprang to the stirrup, and Joris and he. I galloped, Dirk galloped, we galloped all three. Good speed, cried the watch as the gate bolts undrew. Speed, echoed the wall to us galloping through. Behind shut the postern, the lights sank to rest, and into the midnight we galloped abreast. Not a word to each other, we kept the great pace, neck by neck, stride by stride, never changing our place. I turned in my saddle and made its girths tight, then shortened each stirrup and set the peak right, rebuckled the cheek strap, chained slacker the bit, nor galloped less steadily Roland a whit. 'Twas moonset at starting, but while we drew near Loch Erin, the cocks crew and twilight dawned clear. At Boehm, a great yellow star came out to see. At Duffelt, 'twas morning, as plain as could be. And from Mechelen church steeple, we heard the harp chime. So Joris broke silence with, yet there is time. At Aerschot, up leaped of a sudden the sun. And against him the cattle stood black, every one, to stare through the mist that us galloping past. And I saw my stout galloper, Roland, at last, with resolute shoulders, each butting away the haze, as some bluff river headland did spray. And his low head and crest, just one sharp ear bent back for my voice, and the other pricked out on his track. And one eye's black intelligence, ever that glance or its white edge at me, his own master, askance. And the thick, heavy spume flakes, which aye and anon his fierce lips shook upwards in galloping on. By Hasselt, Dirk groaned, and cried, Joris, stay spur! Your roast galloped bravely, the fault's not in her, we'll remember it aches. For one heard the quick wheeze of her chest, saw the stretched neck and staggering knees, and sunk tail and horrible heave of flank, as down on her haunches she shuddered and sank. So we were left galloping, Joris and I, past Lewes and past Tongres, no cloud in the sky. The broad sun above laughed a pitiless laugh, neath our feet broke the brittle bright stubble like chaff. Till over by Dalhelm a dome spire sprang white, and gallop, gasped Joris, for Aix is in sight. How they'll greet us! And all in a moment his roan rolled neck and croup over, lay dead as a stone. And there was my Roland to bear the whole weight of the news which alone could save Aix from her fate. With his nostrils like pits full of blood to the brim, and with circles of red for his eye socket's rim, there I cast loose my buff coat, each holster let fall, shook off both my jack boots, let go belt and all, stood up in the stirrup, leaned, patted his ear, called my Roland his pet name, my horse without peer, clapped my hands, laughed and sang, any noise, bad or good, till at length into Aix Roland galloped and stood. And all I remember is friends flocking round as I sat with his head twixt my knees on the ground. And no voice but was praising this Roland of mine as I poured down his throat our last measure of wine, which the burgesses voted by common consent was no more than his due, who brought good news from Ghent.